الله الرحمن الرحيم نحمده ونصلي على رسول الكريم أما بعد فيخبره عصاه بما أحدث أهله بعده. One possible meaning is through a person's hands he has a control that will control things around him. It's another language, the frequency of a remote control where he switches on the TV, where he gets things to move, the curtains move, the screen goes on, lights go off, etc. And another possible meaning, through his hand, where chips will be installed on his hand. And now the chip will able to give him access to different places, get things to move, get situations and halat around him to be procured by the movement of his hand. And another possible meaning is this cell phone, this technology, which makes you God. Ana Rabbukumul A'la. It takes a person to a level where he goes to shirk and ascribes partners to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If we just take one example, the iPhone in your hand, that makes a person like a God. A smartphone, and I'm specifically speaking about Apple as an example. The first computer that was sold, Apple One, was priced at $666.66. 666 is a sign of Shaitan. Likewise, in these phones we have Google Chrome. This Chrome sign is the sign of one eye. You are supporting Dajjal and Iblis. Likewise, each angle gives you a 6, a 666. Look at Vodafone. Also sixes. Look at Walt Disney, sixes. These are all the signs of Shaitan. So a person who has the Shaitan in his hand, firstly, like how Harry Potter commanded the demons to do the satanic work, through voice recognition Siri, you will instruct the Shayateen to do your work from all forms of evil. Secondly, a person will play videos, he will watch live streams. Live streaming is showing you what's happening in an entire world. Likewise, through videos, a person is going back in time, he's traveling to the past, that is time travel. A video through the eye of Shaitan and Dajjal, which records time, means one can go back in time. You are doing time travel and you are seeing the past. This is a crystal ball where a person sees the past, where he sees the future, where he sees things that are happening in the world. It was never done before. Satanic crystal ball. You move your hand, you move this device, things happen. A magical wand, a satanic stick, a broom, a witch's broom allowed witches to move and to travel. Now you are on your broom and you are traveling like a sorcerer which is fueled by Iblis. Likewise, evil spirits have the ability to sense things which man cannot sense. Sense motion, sense proximity, sense light, different senses, gyroscope, etc. Like how a spirit could sense things. This instrument has become a satanic spirit. Likewise, you sign a contract with the devil. A person uploads his data in the cloud of Shaitan. Like he is signing a contract. That's why a person has allegiance with that device, because he's got a contract with Dajjal, with Shaitan. Imagine now with crystal balls and magic wands and contracts and time travel, what will be the result? This apple is the apple which Adam alayhi salam consumed. Shaitan took an oath, لَأُغْوِيَنَّهُمْ أَجْمَعِينَ. I will not rest, I will not be at peace until I take every one of them. And he started with Adam alayhi salam. When Adam alayhi salam consumed that apple, like how he fell from the eyes of Allah, from Jannah into Dunya. When you bite on this apple, they are telling you, you will fall from the eyes of Allah. You will fall from this Dunya directly into Jahannam. Take this bite. We promise in you Jannah. We promise in you paradise. Look on the screen. Just to the touch of the button, moving your hands, you can access every guna you can fathom. We are giving you Jannah. We are giving you life forever. Because put your life, put your pictures, put your videos on our cloud. Even when you're in the grave, you'll be remembered. But all you need to do is take a bite which Shaitan is offering you. Adam alayhi salam took one bite. Allah protect us today, every minute, every second, every hour of the day. People are taking the bites of Iblis. Can you imagine what's going to happen? This is transhumanism, where they want to advocate the transformation of this insan. If we look in their books, paganism, the joining of man and animals, that was in those days. The big Dajjal is a big animal. Separate topic we'll discuss of how he will come, his Messiah and the deception. But paganism, now they want to do the same concept, but they don't need animals. There's a bigger, more dangerous, more disastrous animal. And that's just technology, where they've developed sophisticated technologies which will enhance this human being and will blend humans with technology. And that's called transhumanism. And this cell phone now, these instruments are part of this great plan. When any nation reached a climax in their peak of their invention, and eventually they thought so, Ana Rabbukum al-A'la, we are the ultimate power, we are the supreme beings, Man ashaddu minna quwwa, we ultimate, we have reached the pinnacle, the zenith, the epitome, not of gods, not of Allah's creation, we are gods. We look at the acceleration of technology. Remember when they reached their peak, two things happened. They declared uluhiyat, we are gods. Secondly, it was their destruction and downfall. Last 1900 years compared to the last 100 years, from the 19th century to the millennium, not so much was developed compared to the 100 years. And from the millennium to 2020, not in the 100 years or the last 2000 years was developed. And researchers say what will be developed in the next 10 years would not have been seen or developed. But remember, it is a follow-up. It is a follow-up. Just to understand, Chris Barnard, heart transplant, 1967, 3rd December. He was able to do that because there was a backdrop of technology previously. If he never had certain technologies, he could not have done it. So the small signs that we are witnessing today is a preparation for the big sign, Dajjal. The small shayateen are a preparation for the big Dajjal, the big shaitan. If I cannot resist the small shaitans, whether it is through this instrument in the palms of our hand, the shaitans of Hollywood, the shaitans of Bollywood, the shayateen of the music industry, the shayateen of the sports industry, whatever idol you have in your heart, and your idols will be what, who you follow. Your idols will be who you have pictures. Olden days was on the walls. Now it's on your wall, your wallpaper. If it's on your wallpaper, it's in the wall of your heart. If the small Dajjal is in my heart, how will I resist the big Dajjal? After knowing all of this year, one must wonder, do I want to be amongst the greatest warriors that will set foot on this earth? Hazrat Mahdi, one of the greatest villains that will come to earth, Dajjal. Do I fit the criteria or not? Is my amal, is my iman, is my taqwa, is my abstinence from guna, is my tilawat of Quran, is my standing up in the darkness of the night on that level that I would fit the criteria. If Mahdi has to interview me today, will I fit the criteria or not? After knowing all of this, seeing this evolution, seeing the destruction in front of us, yet we have the same routine of eating, sleeping, working, disobeying. When will the time come? Hadith Ibn Ibban and Abi Huraira, Inna Allaha yubghidhu ja'adhadhirin jawadhin sakhabin bil aswaq. Allah hates, Allah despises the very rude, obstinate, stubborn, proud, arrogant person who with arrogance and a loud voice, uncivil, argues and quarrels and make controversies with people around him. Jifatim bil layl. Nabi alayhi salam is describing him. Jifatim bil layl. He's a dead corpse at night. He's sitting in front of the PlayStation. He's sitting in front of pornography. He's sitting under his cell phone screen like a jifa, a dead corpse, not for 1 minute, 2 minutes, but for hours and hours on end. He will miss his Isha Salat. He will miss his Fajr Salat. He's a dead corpse, no value to Allah and His Rasul. Jifa, a loving corpse. مثل الذي يذكر ربه والذي لا يذكر كمثل الحي والميت. If you do not remember Allah, you are a dead corpse. That person who spends the night on the musalla is a loving corpse. That person who goes to sleep following the sunnah of Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam is a loving corpse. And that person who goes to sleep falling asleep with a cell phone in his hand, falling asleep with Dajjal in his heart, falling with a TV screen and a PlayStation in front of him, is a jifa. Himarim bin Nahar. I'm quoting verbatim the words of Janabi Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Himarim bin Nahar. A donkey, a mule in the day. Look how a mule works and slugs and has no objective. It does not achieve anything except slogging and becoming the slave of dunya. This person in the night is the slave of Iblis, in the day is the slave of dunya. Alimim bi amri dunya. Ask him anything about soccer scores, and ask him anything about the latest series that was revealed. Ask him about any player, any musician, any dunyawi people, any things about dunya. Alim, he will have an answer. Walakin jahilim bi amri al-akhirah. Ask him about akhirat. Ask him about the masail of fiqh. Ask him about the life of Janabi Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Ask him simple questions. A 3-year-old knows how to use a smartphone. They know it better than a 60-year-old person, but they don't even know how to read the kalima properly. They are void of this hidayat. They are void of the knowledge of deen. Nabi alayhi salam described this type of people that will come in the ummat. Inna Allah yubghidhu. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala despises these types of people. We need to understand and realize, أَلَمْ يَأْنِ لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَن تَخْشَعَ قُلُوبُهُمْ لِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ. Allah is asking us, when will the time come? When? What are you waiting for? That when you hear the talks of deen, you hear akhirat, you hear the kalam of Allah, that your heart does not tremble with fear, yet you become more blatant and you become more brazen and you increase your disobedience and you declare war with Allah. Firstly, these alat will control our minds. Secondly, like Adam alayhi salam, when he bit that apple, it took away their haya, their modesty. It made them lose their clothes. When you hold this instrument in your hands, you will lose your haya and modesty. This has been discussed in detail. Number three, it's preparing the minds for the coming of Dajjal. Look at Disney and the subliminal messages that are coming out in these avenues. They are showing and they are promoting the world to be invaded. Whether it's invaded by aliens or invaded by machines or invaded by whatever. And some of these forms are the actual forms of jinnat, how in real life they look. The jinnat are looking forward to the time where they can come in their natural form. Man is not afraid of the jinns and not supposed to be afraid, but a time will come where the jinnat will openly display themselves in clubs, in VIP rooms. They come in their original form in exorcisms. In other rituals, they make their appearance and they manifest themselves. They are preparing you for the real manifestation and the invasion by machines, so that this transhumanism concept will become live, will become real. Number four, keep us indoors so the mizaj of Dawat, the mizaj of striving in a path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the mizaj, the mindset of going to the masajid and bringing the amal of nubul alive will die. That heart will be dead. That person will be in his house like a dead corpse. Number five, they will show you mystical powers and they will show you the satanic dimensions, whether it's again through Disney, whether it's through movies. They will show you unseen worlds. They will show you unseen powers. Example, Harry Potter, magic, deception, witchcraft, Satanism, immodesty. All of these concepts, they will show you, so you become used to it. You become attracted to it and you become part of their jamaat now. Likewise, superheroes, extraterrestrial people who will have power. Shaitan's gonna give you this power so that you have a desire from a young age. In the last stages, where they will not be shy, besides all of this, they will openly show you the Messiah. They will show you that the Messiah, the Masih is coming. Masihud Dajjal or Masih Isa ibn Maryam. Isa alayhi salam is the real Masih, but the issue is, the fake Isa will come. And generally, when a people have i'tamad and reliance on the fake one, then they disbelieve the real one. So Dajjal will come. He'll say, I am the savior, I am the Isa alayhi salam of the zamana. And he will do the same miracles, yet he will better what Isa alayhi salam did. And billions of people on the earth will follow this Dajjal, Al-Masih Dajjal, thinking he's Masih Isa ibn Maryam. We need to come out of this dhoka and deception. Let us turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let us make tawbah. Let us have a revolution in our life. Kullu ibn Adam khatta'un. Every son of Adam makes errors. Wa khayru al-khatta'in at-tawwabun. Make excessive tawbah and istighfar. If Allah gives a person tawfiq, let us read this dua. Man ra'a mubtallan. Whoever sees somebody in any difficulty, hardship, sickness, etc., and he reads, Alhamdulillah alladhi afani mimma btalaka bih wa faddalani ala kathirin mimman khalaka tafdila lam yusibu dhalika albala. That calamity will not befall him. Whether ulama explain, whether it is sicknesses, whether it is poverty, whether it is the disobedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, 7 times at least, morning and evening, let us try to read this dua and ponder all the sicknesses in the world, all the diseases, all the fitness. Allah protect us. Wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.